Now, unlike modern cars, which are fitted with steering racks, our little Serena is fitted with a steering box. Now, those parts do the same job, but unfortunately, the steering box is slightly more prone to excessive wear. So if I now turn the steering wheel, nothing's actually happening at the road wheel, which means when you're driving along, it's going to have this horrible wayward feeling, and in fact, really isn't going to give you any confidence behind the wheel. So clearly, something has to be done.
To get the steering box out, first I have to release the steering column, which begins by taking the indicators off. Make sure you make a note of which wires go where, so that you know how to put them back together again. Might even be worth taking a quick photo, just for reference. There are two bolts under the dash that release the steering column. The steering box is under the radiator, so I need to drain the radiator, disconnect the pipework, undo a couple of retaining nuts, and then the radiator simply lifts out. The split pins are removed and the castle nuts undone. I then use a splitter to separate each joint. Once the steering rods and wiring are released, the steering box can be removed.
So having got the steering box and the column out of the car, I now need to look deep inside to try and work out if anything's salvageable or repairable. And to do that, of course, I need to take it all apart.
Unlike a modern rack and pinion system, the Serena has a steering box which uses a worm gear and a roller to convert the rotary motion of the wheel to a lateral movement of the steering arm. It's a simple system, but not known for its precise steering feel, and it's prone to wear.